Solving equations by factoring. Simplify first. Before we make the equation equal to zero, we may have to simplify first. So that means that if we have something like the equation in example one, where we've got lots of stuff happening on the left-hand side, we are going to want to simplify before we start to move everything over to one side. So, right here, what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to distribute. So 2x times x will give me 2x squared. 2x times 4 will give me 8x. And then on the right-hand side, we've still got 3x minus 3. So now I want to try and get everything over to one side and make sure that the coefficient in front of my x squared is going to be positive. And it already is, so I'll go ahead and move everything over to the same side as my x squared term. So minus 3x plus 3. So then I'll come up with 2x squared plus 5x plus 3 equals 0. So now I have my expression set equal to 0, so I want to factor. And on the left-hand side over here, now I need 2x times x to give me this x squared. Then I'm going to need something to multiply to this 3, so I'm going to go plus 3 plus 1. And then if I check my outside terms and my inside terms, I've got 2x times 1 will give me 2x. 3x times x will give me 3x. 2x plus 3x will give me 5x. Good. Okay. So now that I have this successfully factored, I want to take each factor and set it equal to 0. Okay. 2x equals negative 3. Minus sign. So minus 1, minus 1, x equals negative 1. So here I have my two possible answers. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at example 2. So again, I've got a lot of stuff happening over here on the left-hand side, so I'm going to have to simplify before I can set it equal to 0. So, we're going to have to do some foiling over here. First terms, so the first terms together are going to give me 6x squared, and then the outside terms are going to give me plus 2x, and my inside terms is minus 9x, and my last terms is minus 3. Okay, minus 8x minus 1. Okay, so now that I've simplified, the next step is going to be to move everything to one side of the equation so that the equation will equal to 0. Well, actually I should probably simplify a little bit farther, make sure that I've got all of my like terms combined here. Minus 7x minus 3 equals negative 8x minus 1. Okay, so now we're ready to move everything over to one side, set it all equal to 0. I've got a positive coefficient in front of my x squared, so I'll move everything over to the same side as that. Plus 8x plus 1. So here I've got 6x squared plus x minus 2 equals 0. Okay, now that everything's set equal to 0, I'm ready to factor. So when I factor, looking for something that'll multiply to this 6x, let's try 3x and 2x. Then I need something to multiply to this negative 2. So let's try plus 2 and minus 1. So if I multiply together the outsides, I'll get minus 3x. Multiply together the insides, I'll get 4x. 4x minus 3x will give me this plus x in the middle. Good. Okay. So now I've factored, and I can take each factor and set it equal to 0. 3x plus 2 equals 0. 2x minus 1 equals 0. Okay, and then the last step is just to go ahead and solve for x. Divide both sides by 3. X equals negative 2/3. Over here, we need to add 1 to both sides. 2x equals 1, divide by 2. And so then we come up with x equals 1/2. Okay, there you go. We've got two different solutions. Don't be afraid of fractions.